Hello, my old chum.
It's GTM here, and I'm gonna show you the top 10 memes that I would consider candidate for Meme of the Decade. I first heard about memes in 2013 when I was playing around on Google in the computer lab during late elementary and middle school years. I thought it was either pronounced meme or meme. And now, we will start with the first meme I can remember stumbling upon, which is number 10.
You like Krabby Patties, don't you, Squidward?
Some of the first memes I found were SpongeBob memes, and I really like the "You like Krabby Patties, don't you, Squidward?" That giant squished grin really set me off on the highway of memes, and that's why I give it the number 10 spot of Meme of the Decade.
Number 9.
In Soviet Russia, memes make you. This meme is that anything backwards from normal happens in Soviet Russia, and this joke is as old as capitalist Russia. But it became really more popular back in 2011, and I even used it recently when I saw someone carrying a stuffed horse on their back, and I said, "In Soviet Russia, horse ride you."
John Cena!
Before I heard of the John Cena meme, I thought memes were just images only. Memes in video form I just thought of as YouTube poops, vines, remixes, edits, bloopers, or just funny videos. In mid-2015, I was watching some John Cena videos with friends, and when I went on YouTube, every video with unexpected John Cena had the word meme next to it. Seeing that helped me redefine what a meme was, and it gave to the rise of more memes in video form that weren't YouTube poops, edits, remixes, bloopers, or funny videos in general. That's why I give John Cena the number 8 spot for Meme of the Decade.
A number 7.
Bruh.
I first heard of bruh in 2014. I always thought it was short for bro, are you fucking serious? It kinda tailed off in 2015, but in the middle of 2019, it came back as bruh sound effect number 2. And it gave to the rise of bruh remixes and certified bruh memes. This meme managed to appear twice in a decade, so that's why I place it as number 7. Number 6, press F to pay respects. This image came from a PC version of Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, where the player presses F to pay respects. I first saw this image around 2017, and soon the letter F was used when anything bad happens, both sincerely and as a joke. Instead of RIP, we now get an F in the chat. Number 5, the Lenny face. In late 2015, I noticed that someone typed this face that wasn't sideways or a shocked face. I soon learned that this guy was called Le Lenny face, or Lenny. Kind of become the punctuation mark to mean, "I know what you mean is quite rude," just like a question mark is for confusion. Number 4, the dab. In January 2016, I was browsing SpongeBob memes again and found this image of Squidward. I also found similar versions with the word dab incorporated. I soon found other people and characters doing that same pose, and by the end of the year, everyone was doing it. Not only was it the first meme to become a body motion, but it was the first meme I noticed to become so popular that even small children and the elderly found out about it. I still see some dab memes to this day, and I sometimes dab myself on rare occasions. Number 3. The air horn and MLG. I first heard the air horn sound effect when I was doing exercises in middle school gym class to some upbeat remix. I soon heard the sound again while watching a YouTube poop, and then hearing the entire songs just using the air horn. It made me realize that any noise can be remixed to any sound and not be called a YTPMV. But the remixed sound being its own meme. It also made me discover what is Illuminati, the importance of 420 and weed, and getting back at it again with the white Vans. Number 2, the Super Crown / Bowsette. On September 13, 2018, Nintendo released the trailer for new Super Mario Bros. U Deluxe and Knuckles Simulator 64 with new funky mode. I was a fan of Mario well before discovering memes. I don't like Nintendo just re-releases of the exact same games from the Wii U onto the Switch with very few changes. The only changes are you can play as Toadette and the Super Crown power-up, which can turn her into a form of Princess Peach called Peachette. Less than 5 days later, AYYK92 made this comment, Mick, showing the ending of Mario Odyssey, with Bowser then putting out a Super Crown and then turn into Bowsette. Now literally any character can become a hot, sexy waifu. What do you mean, Rule 63? This is an actual meme that you can beat your meat to. I also consider a combination of my three favorite things, Nintendo, memes, and hentai. Just when you thought there was a finite amount of waifus, there are now infinitely more. Now before we get to number one, I want to get over some honorable mentions who were just shy of the top 10. This drawing of a Luigi sprite from Mario is Missing, it was how I stumbled upon Super Mario 64 bloopers and SMG4. I saw Luigi's face when looking at Mario memes, and how he could turn anyone's face into his. I found this video on YouTube called Super Mario 64 Bloopers, Luigi Disease, and I thought it was some form of short animations like Mario's Funniest Bloopers. But it was a 12-minute story of hilariousness and N64 Mario. I enjoyed it and soon watched more of SMG4's videos, like 99.5% Crazy, Toad Gold, and Two Evil Friends. I have been subscribed to SMG4 for 6 years and I hope someday to make my own Mario 64 bloopers, but I will call them Super Mario 69s or something different.
Daniel UK, 99% of the time you hear a text-to-speech voice, it's this guy. He is still relevant to this day and you can make him say a bunch of bullshit and it will always sound funny. Suck my Harry Long dick, you stupid fuck.
Troll. The troll face is probably the most iconic Rage comic face. But the use of Rage comics died out by 2015, but I still like to listen to the Trollololo song, aka I'm Very Glad Because I Am Coming Home. It was even recognized by the Trollololo guy himself, Edward Keel, and Google. But for the number one meme of the 2010s, we have a tie. For number 1A, we have We Are Number One. In September 2016, people started doing remixes of this LazyTown song. I didn't really watch much LazyTown as a kid, mainly because I was terrified of those puppets and the makeup used on the human actors. A few people were doing remixes of the song, including ones where But Robbie Rotten does this every time they say one. The meme grew when Stefan Carl Stephenson, the guy who played Robbie Rotten, announced he was diagnosed with cancer, which resulted in people who were unable to donate to make more We Are Number One memes to support Stefan. That was the main reason I started Glitchy Triagonal Memes, to make We Are Number One memes to support Stefan. Although Stefan played a villain on TV, he was a hero and number one. He was dedicated to his family and soon left social media to spend time with his family. Although the meme went cold in 2017, I don't believe in dead memes. It came back after Stefan Carl Stephenson died on August 21st, 2018. More videos came to honor Robbie. As a side note, my cousin's wife gave birth to a baby girl a few days after Stefan Carl died. Part of me thinks Stefan was reincarnated into that little girl. She was not named Stephanie, Carla, Carly, or Roberta, by the way, or any similar name. Number 1B, the Area 51 raid. It all started in June 2019 when some guys create a Facebook event where a bunch of people storm into the highly classified area of Air Force Base in the middle of Nevada and try to see aliens while dodging security on September 20th, 2019. I thought there would actually be people who leave their computers and homes and drive into the middle of Nevada to Naruto Run and clap alien cheeks. Even corporations and news media were hyping it up. Quite a lot of people actually set up camp there and stood in front of the gate of Area 51, but unfortunately, only a few people made it past the gate. I guess they were actually brave and depressed enough to actually do it. There was even this one kid who Naruto ran straight past a news camera and became a sub-meme. I gave it number one because it actually got people out of their homes and met up with each other thousands of miles away. I think on April 20th, we should all raid either Pussy Lake in Ontario, Meme Lake in Minnesota, or Underground Vault and Storage in Hutchinson, Kansas, which has raw master tapes of many movies. Honestly, there are so many good memes out there that couldn't make it into this part, either because they were from before 2010, or I just didn't have much to say about them. I bet most of you didn't even get to this part, but if you did, I want you to help make the 2020s even more revolutionary for memes. So make your memes that change the world. Change the world. My final message, goodbye.